Pancake, flapjack, or swimming frisbee. These are but a few of the nicknames for the great southern stingray. Southern stingrays are a subset of stingrays. Who knew? Rays are closely related to sharks. Most of the time, the southern stingray is a docile fish. It is quite curious. Stingrays eat clams, shrimps, and mussels. The southern stingray's eyes are on top of its body, and its mouth is on the underside. They use a special organ to guide their food to their mouths. The organ is called the ampullae of Lorenzini. This organ consists of gel-filled cells around its mouth. These cells look like freckles when you see them. They are used to pick up minute electrical signals emitting out of animals' muscles and heartbeats. They can hear a heartbeat. Rays can see the prey, they just can't see their mouths, and that is where the ampullae of Lorenzini brings it home. Rays are very hard to provoke. Most ray strikes on humans are caused by a human accidentally stepping on them. Rays like to camouflage themselves with sand in the shallows near the shore. They are very hard to see when they are like this. They have a spine on their tail that is venomous. When provoked, they strike like a scorpion's. Wow! Always drag your feet as you walk into the ocean. That way you will make sure that if there is a ray in the area, he will either hear you or he will see you before you get there. Rays have a cartilage skeleton. Cartilage! It's the bendable stuff that holds your ear up. Southern rays have small openings called spiracles on top of their heads. The location of these spiracles enables the stingray to take in water while lying on the seabed or when partially buried in sediment. Water enters the spiracle and leaves through the gill. This is how they breathe while they're hid. Rays communicate through pheromone signaling. What is that? They actually talk through smell. In many parts of the Caribbean, the southern stingray swims with divers and snorkelers. The southern stingray is found in tropical and subtropical waters of the Western Atlantic Ocean, our side of the pond, from New Jersey to Brazil. Southern stingrays can reach up to 5 feet wide and 160 pounds. You will probably swim by the first 10 southern stingrays before you will see one. Don't worry, it takes time to know what to look for. As always, only observe. Never go into the water alone, and most importantly, leave only footprints in the sand. If you've enjoyed today's video, click that like button over there and click subscribe so you will know when we're posting videos. And I'll see you next time on Undersea G.